الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا والصلاة والسلام على أشرف خلق الله إمام الأنبياء وسيد ولد بني آدم أجمعين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is the second session regarding our topic, disease of the heart and its cure. And I will just make a quick revision of what we have started last week, then we will go to our topic today. As it is written here, number one, within the heart, some general talk about the heart. And then we will go through some verses from the Quran talking about the hearts in the Quran. And you will find that there is many, many ayat talking about the heart in the Quran and its different types, its character, symptoms and signs. Then we will go through some ahadith of the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, especially hadith number 1 and number 6, which I mentioned last week. I mean by number 1 and 6 in al-Arba'in al-Nawawiyyah. Hadith number 1 about intention and hadith number 6 about al-halal wal-haram and the mursal of in the body, which is the heart. We will go through tafsir of verses, ayat al-Qur'an in Surah al-Baqarah from ayah 1 to ayah 19. Ayat Surah al-Baqarah, here we will find two types of the hearts are mentioned very clear. The hearts of the kuffar and the hearts of the hypocrites. If we have time, we will go through the main issue here about the types of the hearts in more details and how the scholars, by analyzing, investigating and going through, reflecting through the ayat and the hadith, at the end of the day, they divided the types of the hearts into three types. Qalb salim, healthy, sound, okay. This is the, of course, of the believers. And there are subtitles here. Then we have qalb marid, marad, yani sick, illness, diseased. And this also have subtypes, we will go through it. And dead hearts, qulub mayyita, dead, qasiyah. It has no response. And we will find that it will be described as it is sealed, or it is stamped, or it is very hard as the rocks. Inshallah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us and make the best benefit of this gathering, inshallah. I would like also to remind my sons and daughters that we want you to work hard within this topic. It is not a matter just to spend your time or just to have knowledge. No, it is hujjah. It is a matter that we have to reflect upon and we have to apply it in our life. Al-Qur'an hujjatun laka aw alayk, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. So it be for you or it will be against you. And this knowledge is very important to achieve and to apply it in your life. It is not a theory. We are not talking just to spend our time or to talk about some theories which has no relation to us. No. Al-Qur'an wa sunnah is our life. Al-Qur'an wa sunnah is our life. We are living to practice the Qur'an and sunnah. We are living to worship our Lord, our Rabb, according to the Quran and Sunnah. And as I mentioned last week, it is your heart. The place of Iman, it is the place of Kufr, it is the place of hypocrisy, Nifaq. It is the place of Fisq. Your heart is the initiative organ in the body, it is the king. And what you are doing is just reflecting what is in your heart. We are reflecting what is in our heart. Your sayings, your deeds, your wills, it is your heart. The believer heart will act according to the faith in it, the light in it. And the dark kafir heart, he will act according to it. And we will go to the hypocrites also, with its two types. Major hypocrisy, which is kufr, appearing as a Muslim, and minor hypocrisy. He is a Muslim, but the struggle, the battlefield in his heart comes sometimes positive, right, sometimes to the left or to the negative. Yani, upside down, sometimes good, sometimes bad. And there are some characters of hypocrisy, practical hypocrisy. This way can affect any Muslim, any believer, man or a woman. Let's say again that we mentioned that the heart is the king. And all the organs of the body are its soldiers. The heart is the most honorable part of the man's body. It is the part which knows Allah. Look to what Imam Abu Hamid al-Ghazali said in Ihya Ulum al-Din. It works for Allah, seeks to draw near Allah, feels the value of his bounties and his favors. All the organs are follower to your heart. Whoever knows his heart will know his Rabb, his Lord. And most people, unfortunately, they are ignorant of their hearts and they don't care about their hearts. Here he says that the heart is prepared for accepting the guidance or rejecting it. Yani, it can be guided to the truth and it can be directed to the false, to the bad. You have the capability for both of them. And it is your will and your intention to choose. And in the heart, the battle between, or the struggle between the good and the bad. The malaika and the shayateen, the angels and the devils. And you, whatever will overcome, you will be following it. And this is what we are talking about. We want our heart to be protected from the evil. We want our heart to be on the straight path. We want to keep the iman in the heart. We want to block all the ways of the devils and the enemies which want us to withdraw from the straight path. And the ayah which we all know, وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَى قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. In the surah of وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَاهَا وَالسَّمَاءِ وَمَا بَنَاهَا وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا طَحَاهَا وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا. 7 oaths. Allah swear, make an oath by the moon, the sun, the sky, the heaven, the earth, and by the soul who created it. Then Allah says, I swear that he will be successful who will purify his soul. He will be a loser who doesn't purify his soul. أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. So you have the capability, you have the ability to go to the right and to go to the left. And Allah gave us eyes, ears, sensation, and mind. You reflect, you understand, you can analyze. We have the mind. Last week we talked a little bit about, is the brain or is the mind in the heart? And we said that there are some ayat of the Quran talking about the heart which reflect and understand. It is very clear. And here Imam Ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah, the great scholar of Saudi Arabia, alayhi rahmatullah, he has one in his tafsir of Riyad al-Salihin and al-Arba'in al-Nawawiyyah. Wonderful books of this great scholar, alayhi rahmatullah. He was with the opinion that it is the heart. Al-Aql fi al-Qalb. It is the heart which understands. It is the heart which reflects. It is the heart which analyzes. The data comes to the brain, no problem. You have your eyes, optic nerves, you have your ears, you have sensation from the tongue, whatever, and all of this goes to the brain. But the decision and the analysis of this data comes from the heart. يعقلون. And the ayah here was very clear, which we mentioned last time. وَلَقَدْ ذَرَأْنَا لِجَهَنَّمْ كَثِيرًا أَفَلَمْ يَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ فَتَكُونَ لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ يَعْقِلُونَ بِهَا. This is in Surah Al-Hajj 46. Allah mentioned the hearts that they reflect and understand by it. And he mentioned the kuffar that their hearts doesn't reflect, doesn't understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hajj, the ayah number 46. Instead of saying verses, it is ayat. Surah and ayah and juz. No need for this English translation. Khalas. From here and then we will say Surah Al-Hajj. Al-ayah raqam 46. Where Allah says, have they not traveled in the land and have their hearts understand, wherewith to understand, and the ears wherewith to hear? Verily, it is not the eyes that grow blind, but it is the hearts which are in the breasts that grow blind. فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَلْ أَبْصَارِ وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَلْ قُلُوبِ أَلَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. What does it mean? The heart goes blind. يعني, it doesn't understand. فإمام ابن عثيمين رحمه الله, الشيخ ابن عثيمين, he was the opinion that it is the heart which reflect. We will go through this also with other ayat. The second ayah here. وَلَقَدْ ذَرَأْنَا لِجَهَنَّمْ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنْسِ لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ آذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا أُولَئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْغَافِلُونَ. So this ayah says that there are some human beings, they have hearts which they do not understand by it. Use it for understanding. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is the ayah number 179. I think this is Surah Al-A'raf. And surely we have created many of the jinn and mankind for hell. They have hearts wherewith they understand not. And they have eyes wherewith they see not, and they have ears wherewith they hear not, i.e. the truth. They are like cattle, nay, even more astray. Those, they are the heedless ones. Another ayah talking about the hearts which reflect and which understand. So, it is something very secret in the hearts of the human beings. The heart of the human being. It is not only the pump of blood which works before birth till your death. 24 hours, 7 days. No rest at all, no holiday. It is working day and night, pumping, receiving the oxygenated blood, sending blood to the lungs, then receiving the oxygenated blood, sending the oxygenated blood to whole body. Very secret. And when you study, if you study medicine, you will know. It has its own special electric system, own special nervous system. It has something that makes it work by itself, which is called SA node, beating day and night. While you are sleeping or walking, you are going. And you can feel your heart in many occasions when you are very scared or fearing. When you are in love, normal love, you will see beating. In many occasions, feelings. When you are very angry, there is a suprarenal gland. It will secrete a special hormone. And this hormone, when you are very angry, it makes the heart beat very quickly. and you find the blood goes to your face and the angry person appears, the heart is working with all the feelings. And we say, I have peace in my heart. Rest. اطْمَأَنَّ قَلْبِي. And Allah said, وَيَشْفِ غَيْظَ قُلُوبِهِمْ. There are also غَيْظ, some sort of anger in the heart, which can be revealed. Relaxation of the heart. Happiness, we always say, happiness is in the heart. It is not a materialistic matter. You are happy when you feel happiness in your heart. Something which was mentioned also in the Daily Mail newspaper, and it is also a little bit with our topic, transplantation of the heart. What happens if there is a person who is sick and ill, he needs a heart to be transplanted? And they made this transplantation. Of course, this is one of the major operations, but now it succeeds. Imagine that in some cases, the personality of the dead person from whom we took the heart comes to a certain extent to the ill person whom the heart was implanted in. The story here about a man who was a good man doing good deeds, and he was very kind to other people. And then he got a stroke in his heart. A dead person at that time, he assassinated himself, he killed himself. So they took his heart and they implanted this heart to the first one. The Daily Mail wrote in the 10th of 4th, 2008. They said that it was amazing that many of the characters of the dead person were transformed to the healthy one after the heart was implanted. He said here that the man who was nice and kind turned to be a bad man. And he was a believer before then, because the heart which was transferred to him, implanted to him, it was from an atheist. So they said that the iman of the man who it was transplanted, the heart was transplanted to him, become lower and lower. And he started doing very bad things which he hadn't done before. And also they said that when he saw the wife of the dead person, he told her that as if I know you very well, and he wanted to be with her as if she is his own wife. Also another story, a good Muslim man, this was in an Arabic word, and after a heart was transplanted to him, it was from a man who didn't pray, he was not practicing. Then the believer man, the good man, after this operation, they said he began to be very weak in his prayer, and he began to ask for drinking alcohol and beer and something like this. It is not a proof, or this is not the case every time, but we want to say that there is some secrets, and still till now the cells of the body is a secret. If you remember a few years ago when George W. Bush, before Obama, when they found the secrets of some of the DNA in the cells, there is very secret issues in every cell of the body. As a huge computer, all the data comes in very, very minute cells. And this is also, when we are talking about the heart, the feelings, the way of thinking. So let us again come to say, the heart is mentioned a lot in the Quran. And the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, at-taqwa ha-huna, at-taqwa ha-huna, at-taqwa ha-huna. Faith, taqwa, piety is in the heart. And the other hadith also, which we always say, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَى صُوَرِكُمْ وَأَجْسَامِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَى قُلُوبِكُمْ وَأَعْمَالِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, verily Allah doesn't look at your bodies or your shapes, but He looks at your hearts. And then he pointed to his chest. He pointed to his chest. Hadith narrated by Imam Muslim. So it is an authentic hadith, 100%. The other hadith which we mentioned, hadith number 6, there is a morsel in the body. If it is sound, everything will be sound and health. The Rasul said it is the heart. Ayat talking about the heart, we will go through some ayat and you will look to this amazing things to know that as the heart was described in the Arabic literature word, it is qalb, al-qalb. And it is said that it is named qalb because it is tataqallab, yaqlib, yanqalib, qalaba. Qalb, يعني yaqlib, يعني to make it upside down. And here Imam Abu Hamid al-Ghazali also mentioned this, and he said this is something also very important to understand the word, the root word, the root of the word qalb, yataqallab. And this is because it is easily to be changed. He said that the heart, as we said, it is prepared for guidance, to accept guidance as well because of its nature, but it may not accept it in respect to its desires and wishes. The heart remains a field of struggle between angels, soldiers of good, and shayateen, the devils, soldiers of evil. So we will say shaytan, يعني ملائكة, يعني angels. And this is the battlefield in your heart, between both of them. The shayateen pushing you towards the haram, towards sinning. And there is a wonderful article of Imam Ibn al-Qayyim in his book Tafsir al-Mu'awwadatayn, explanation of قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ and قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. There is a wonderful book. Imam Ibn al-Qayyim and Ibn Taymiyyah. The book is also, Ibn Taymiyyah wrote a paragraph of it. Talking about the shaitan and his target with you. What does the shaitan want from you? His main goal, or the best thing to achieve from you, turn you to be a kafir. Kufr and shirk. He wants you to be a kafir. By any way, kufr and shirk, to associate with Allah, not to worship Allah, to deny and reject, to be an atheist, whatever. If he cannot reach with you this great level, he will push you towards the bid'ah, innovation. Bid'ah. And the bid'ah can be kufr. There are some kufr bid'ah. And the problem with the bid'ah is that you think it is right and you don't leave it. As those, for example, those who having the bid'ah that the Prophet ﷺ is alive with us and he's sitting and they put for him the chair and they say he is hadir nadir. Group of Bereluis. Some of them, this is exaggeration and this is not Islam. So they think that they are right and they are respecting the Prophet ﷺ. They are contradicting the Quran and the Hadith. This is bid'ah. It may be mukaffira if he thinks that Prophet Muhammad is Allah or part of Allah. Muhammad ﷺ doesn't die. He is with us. Like, what's the difference? The Christians say Jesus is Allah and part of Allah. And Jesus doesn't die, they say. When they want anything, they say, Jesus. Jesus. And you say Muhammad, Muhammad. And our deen is based on monotheism. Monotheism يعني لا إله إلا الله. No God but Allah. We cannot associate Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم with Allah. He is the greatest human being. The greatest honorable human being. But he is a human being. He is a human being. Don't go with the bid'ah. Because the, some of the Sufi, they said, all the creation are created for Muhammad. He is light. And again, in Surah Al-Kahf, it is very clear. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيَّ أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدٌ. أنا بشر مثلكم. I am a human being as you. He was born normally. He was a kid. He grown up. He got sick. He wounded, injured. He got married. He eat, drink. And he passed. He died. So why going so astray? And this will affect your faith. And when you ask, ya Muhammad, you are making association to Allah. And imagine the others, the Shia, huge corrupted, deviated sect. They took from the Persian Majus that the holy family and everything is inherited. So they say Ali ibn Abi Talib is ma'soom. He's the same as the Prophet. And his descendants are ma'soomeen. From where is this? Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib is one of the great Sahaba. We highly appreciate Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib. But we don't go in this bid'ah. And because of that, they created their own deen. They said all the Sahaba who came as Khulafa before Ali are criminals. How Abu Bakr took the Khilafah from him? How Uthman? How Umar? All of them are criminals. And in many books, Sahaba are the dogs of hellfire. Why all of this? To build their own religion. They hate the Sunni, they hate the Islam. And I don't want to open the matter of the Shia. This is a big issue. But it is very easy to see what they are doing now in Syria. The massacre in Syria is done by the coward Nusayriyin, extreme Shia, and Iran. Iran sent 10,000 soldiers. And the Hezbollah also sent 4,000 soldiers to fight with Bashar al-Assad. Shia with the Nusayriyin. And the plan of the Shia to make the empire of the Shia. They took Iraq. And they want Syria. And Lebanon. And now fighting for Bahrain. As well they will cut east of Saudi Arabia. They have their own people in Yemen. And they are trying in Kuwait, they are spreading their poison in Morocco, Algeria, Sudan, and in Egypt. Now in Egypt, many these, what you call, Husayniyat, are now established in Egypt, and they are paying thousands and thousands, millions. And their deen is based on what? Ali is the ma'soob. And hatred, cursing all the Sahaba and Ummahat al-Mu'mineen. And they don't believe in our Quran. They have their own interpretation of the Quran. They don't believe in a hadith. Bid'ah, bid'ah, bid'ah. So, the shaitan comes back to you. If he can't turn you to a kafir, a mulhid, a mushrik, and take care of the shirk here, those who go to worship graves. Ya Hussein, Ya Tijani, Ya Mawlana. This is shirk. Shirk Akbar. Shirk Akbar. If you ask anybody rather than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In my country, in Egypt. Al-Badawi. Sayyid Al-Badawi in Tanta. More than 1 million. Goes every year. Every year. Celebrating Mawlid Sayyid Al-Badawi. And they ask him, they slaughter for him, they pay money for him, for 1 week, as Hajj. And they ask, Ya Badawi, cure my son. Ya Badawi, give me money. Ya Badawi, my daughter, let her marry, get married. Ya Badawi, Ya Badawi. Badawi is Allah in their thoughts. Have all the power as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is shirk. Shirk. Shirk billah, shirk akbar. وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. If you are a Muslim, a believer, it is لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله. You have to pure this in your heart. Nothing will benefit you. Nothing will harm you. Nothing will help you. Allah. Allah alone. And this is what we learned from Al-Fatiha. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ إِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ إِيَّاكَ in Arabic. It is للحصر والقصر. Yeah, it is only you whom we worship. It is only you whom we seek help. This is Iman. This is faith which should be established in your heart. So coming back to say that the shaitan, al-waswas, al-khannas, the devil will not leave you if you are a man with knowledge. How can you fight the bid'ah? It is by knowledge, only knowledge. You may find very nice people, Muslimin, but they went astray because lack of knowledge, ignorance. Ignorance, complete ignorance. So whatever it was said to them, they will follow it. You find millions of people. Millions of people are really astray. They are their actions, their deeds, their thoughts against Islam. طيب, you are a knowledgeable man. The shaitan cannot turn you to a mubtadi'. What is the third thing? He will push you to sins, major sins. Inflating into your heart, pushing you. Do haram, especially the major sins. Killing, zina, fornication, adultery, drinking alcohol, stealing, thief. And anything, he will facilitate it in your mind. He will infiltrate your heart, especially when you are angry. In anger, you lose your mind. You don't control yourself. Okay, what about you? Shoya, please, sisters, please. What we can do here, the major sin, if he cannot push you towards it, he will turn you to minor sins. Backbiting, looking bad to others, doing something very bad, swearing, whatever, minors. If you are a very good man, he couldn't turn you to kufr, to bid'ah, to sins, major and minor sins. He will go with you through wasting your time or losing the priorities. Yani, it is time now for salah. As a Muslim, a believer, you have knowledge, the best thing to do is to go to the mosque. So he will tell you, no. You are reading, continue studying your book, for example. Best thing to do, for example, in the last 10 days of Ramadan, i'tikaf or going to Umrah in the whole month of Ramadan. He will tell you, no, do whatever, anything else. Take your wife in a holiday, ولا مش عارف ايه. You wake up in the night. What to do? The best thing to do at night is to pray 2 rak'ah, 4 rak'ah, 6 rak'ah, to make your link with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He may divert you to any other things. So the shaitan, this is the steps of the shaitan. Imam Ibn al-Qayyim wrote this in his wonderful book, Tafsir al-Mu'awadatayn, as well as Ighathat al-Lahfan min Masayid al-Shaytan. So kufr, turn you to kafir, muftadi', turn you to be minor and major and minor sins, fasiq, يعني you don't care. You make the haram and khalas, you want to fulfill your desires. He beautify. You can steal this 1,000 pounds, nobody will see you. You can touch this woman, it will go ahead, no problem. Nobody will account you. Very easy, haram, very easy. What's the problem, yeah? And instead of going to get married and paying dowry and misharifi, why? Take her just 5 minutes or 10 minutes, pay her £10. Khalas. Haram, very easy. Take this cup of alcohol. Oh, you are a kid? You don't drink? You don't smoke? Try this drug. And he will, yani many, many things. He can beautify the haram on you. Taib, you are a good man. And you are fighting the shaitan. Why you are talking all of this? The shaitan, you are his battle. You are his target. And he is with you. He is with you from birth till death. He will never leave you. إن الشيطان يجري من ابن آدم مجرى الدم في العروق running as your blood in the veins. How he works, how it is not our business. It is not our question. Allah created the shayateen, the jinn, and it is in the Quran and in the hadith. We believe in this. We believe in this. Allah created angels. We believe in this. Allah created the heavens, the Jannah, the Nar, and there will be the day of judgment after death. There is the Barzakh after death. We believe in this. What is all of this? Ghaib, the unseen. The unseen. And when we go to Tafsir Surah Al-Baqarah, now the first surah after Al-Fatiha, you will find that the first character of the believers, they believe in the unseen. Allah is unseen, but we know Him very well through the evidence and through the Quran and the Hadith. We believe in the angels, we believe the devils, we believe that Allah sent divine scriptures and Allah sent the Quran, Al-Quran from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Jibreel, the angel, to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for all human beings. We believe. And the ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah, Alif Lam Mim, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. This book, no doubt and suspicion in it, it is the guidance for the pious people. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, الذين يؤمنون بالغيب. They believe of the answer. Where is your belief? Where is your faith? It is in your heart. يؤمنون بالغيب. And then they practice their iman. يقيمون الصلاة. يعني it is not only that saying that I am a believer, I have my faith. لا. يقيمون الصلاة وينفقون مما رزقناهم. طيب now, what is the last thing for the shaitan if he fails with you? Now you are not going to be turned to a kafir. You are not a mubtadi'. You are not going to make sins, major and minor sins. You know the priorities. Alhamdulillah, you have knowledge. What about reciting the Quran? It's great blessings. What about the Salat al-Jama'ah? What about Salat al-Fajr? What about going Umrah and the Hajj? Doing the good deeds, preparing yourself for Ramadan, taking your family for Umrah and Hajj, attending the circles. You know. You know. You are not living haphazard. You are not living as a cattle. We are not running for money or a woman. We are living to worship Him. Khalas. Now the shaitan will fed with you. Fed up. What he will do? Who knows, طيب يلا. شيوخ East London. The شيوخ of East London. What can he do?
Try. You tell it to do something that's less beneficial.
We said it. He is trying to waste your time to do something less beneficial. Sah. Okay, tell me.
Something good, something bad. Something that you think is good, is definitely bad.
We said it. He will try to sahih, to beautify something which is less important or it is bad. He will try. But you have the knowledge. Alhamdulillah. Huh?
Is it like In fact, he's going to make you think you're going to John Lyon.
Sorry?
Is it hypocrisy?
Hypocrisy. Yani he will try to attack you to turn you to a kafir, a fasiq. No, no, we said it. Now, if you remember, we said a surah, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. The great, the ayat which the Prophet ﷺ said, this is the best ayat for protection. Huh? I'll give you a key.
Is it mubah?
Huh?
Going to the mubah.
No. This is also for the priorities. Huh?
Make you think you're it now, you've gone there. They make you arrogant.
Okay, it is the same as we said. He will try with you, or we said major sins, minor sins. Riya can be here as a minor or minor, or it may be a major sin. Arrogance. Huh? Yes.
We make you forget the deen.
The same. Order.
Be your friend and family against you?
Uh-huh. How?
Divide waswasa.
How? قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. Look here now. He fed up with you. He will go with other people against you. We have two things which has no control on it. الحسد. السح. Sorcer. Envy. How can I know that you have an envious eye against me? How can I know that there is an evil man or evil woman who did sih? Very, very, something, it is beyond my hand now. And because of that, it is قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. This is the protection now. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقِ وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبْ وَمِنْ شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ. This is naf. In عقد, يعني knots, the sorcerers who know the sihr. There is many sihr in Asia, Asian countries, in Morocco, in Sudan, in many places, you know, sahara. And the sihr is mentioned in the Quran. One of the sihr is to separate the man from his wife. تبعوا ما تتلو الشياطين على ملك سليمان وما كفر سليمان ولكن الشياطين كفروا يعلمون الناس السحر وما أنزل على الملكين ببابل هاروت وماروت وما يعلمان من أحد حتى يقول إنما نحن فتنة فلا تكفر فيتعلمون منهما ما يفرقون به بين المرء وزوجه وما هم بضارين به من أحد إلا بإذن الله. يعني there are some types of sihr which is haram completely to learn sihr, to practice sihr, to go to a sahir. Haram. Sihr is kufr. Sihr is kufr. What is the penalty of the sahir in the Muslim ummah? Yes. Death. Sah. Death. Death. Sahir yuqt. Because it is part of kufr. First, to make the magician, you have to be a kafir. And use a kafir jinn. And you will harm other people. It is, alhamdulillah, it is not widely spread, or it is not an easy, يعني, but there is sihr, of course, there is sihr. And there is hasad. Hasad. Hasad, يعني envy. You very jealous. Why your brother has يعني, very good fortune, and this car, and this house, and he's running a very good business. And the woman looked to another woman, why she has 5, 6 children, and I have no children. And her heart with bad feelings, envious eyes, she look at her, not jealousy, no, she wants to harm her. She wants this favor, bounce from Allah, to be taken from her. And the hasad, as the shuyukh, the scholars say, it is a very bad feeling in a very bad soul, evil soul. يعني he doesn't want you to have any favors or blessings. يعني he doesn't want this to be for him. This may be يعني accepted to some. No, he wants you to be deprived from it. Why he has this beautiful, pretty girl? Oh, look to his daughter. Ya salam, ya salam, ya salam. And then you find his daughter very sick and ill. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. And it happened at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hasad, it differs from malaise, it differs from hatred. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, recite قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ when you wake up and at night and after salah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this is the most protection you can gain. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقِ, for all any evil he created. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبٍ, the moon at the night, because at night it is more evil. يعني الزنا, fornication, thief, alcohol, everything at night, more than in the morning, daytime. So look, وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبٍ وَمِنْ شَرِّ النَّفَّثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدٍ, and it is more with women, sahara, either a man or a woman. This is ينفث, في العقد, in the knots. وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدٍ, when he starts his envious eye. So now the shaitan will try to push you others. But even if you are a knowledgeable man, a good believer, you have your link with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they can do nothing. Nothing. إِنَّ كَيْدَ الشَّيْطَانِ كَانَ ضَعِيفًا, weak. Allah said, مِنْ شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ. خَنَّاسِ يعني he withdraw, he whisper, صح. But when you say astaghfirullah, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, subhanallah, he will run, he will flee, he is very weak. But if you are weaker, he can overcome you and control you. So, is it time now? طيب, يعني, we will go with the ayat of the Quran regarding the heart, and we will see how the Quran describes the heart, inshallah. And the types of the heart according to the ayat of the Quran. We will have a break, inshallah, 4 or 5 minutes, and then we will continue. Jazakumullah khair, wa sallallahu ala Muhammad, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Qalb al-salim, the sound heart. Number 2, the diseased heart. And number 3, the dead heart. And each one of them has different descriptions and subcategories. As well as the hearts can be changed from one to another. Yani, a believing heart, a live heart, a good heart, sound heart can turn to be a diseased one. And from a diseased heart, it can be a dead heart. Yani, you can lose your iman can weaken and reach to the bottom. You can become a hypocrite with a diseased heart. And you may lose iman completely and you turn to be a kafir. A diseased heart also can be cured if it is of the minor type, when we will go through it, and it can turn to be a sound heart if it is treated. The dead heart, if it is dead with the descriptions of the Quran, nothing will benefit it. And we will know why. It is dead, it is sealed, it is stamped. There is no way. It is full of desires and lusts. It is astray. It is deviated. It is a heart which is dead from accepting any guidance. Many of the kuffar are like this. The truth is very clear, but they refuse it. Khalas, no way. The healthy heart and the diseased heart and the sick heart. Let us start by the ayah which we all know. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. The day when wealth and the sons avail not any person, any man, save him who brings unto Allah a sound heart. Nothing will avail you in the day of judgment. Only a sound heart. يعني قلب سليم. How can I make my heart سليم? What is the characters of القلب السليم? How can I protect my heart? So that when I die with قلب سليم. Allah says, nothing will benefit you, nothing will avail you. No wealth, no sons, nobody. It is only your clean, clear, sound, healthy heart. So if your heart is corrupted, if your heart is diseased, it is a serious matter. And as the scholars say, the problem is, in many cases, or the majority, they don't feel this sickness. They don't try to cure the spiritual sickness of their heart. If your heart is pathologically affected, or your body, you will run to the doctor. Pain in my belly, pain, and so on, indigestion, headache, toothache, whatever, you run. But what about a sick, diseased, ill heart? We will go through this. You will find that there are many, many types of the diseased hearts. Yani, the envy and hatred are parts of it. But there are other things. Weak iman is something which is an illness in your heart. You don't care. You don't think about akhirah. You are heavily indulged in dunya. You are running for your lusts and desires. And we will see that between the diseased heart and the dead heart, it is very sensitive matter. Because this sickness, if you don't cure it, it will affect your heart at the end of the day. Hadith Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the ayah in the Quran before it. Kalla bal rana ala qulubihim ma kanu yaksibun. Kalla bal rana ala qulubihim ma kanu yaksibun. Rana, it is a block. It will happen on, it will got on their hearts because of their sins. And the Hadith Hudhaifa, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whenever you sin, it is a black dot in your heart. Whenever you sin, it is a black dot in your heart. If you repent, it will be clean. If not, it will continue. Sinning after sinning after sinning, blacking, 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 till your heart will be completely black. It will be blocked. Khalas. Finished. And the other hadith, تُعْرَضُ الذُّنُوبُ عَلَى الْقُلُوبِ كالحصير عودا عودا فأيما قلب أشربها نكت فيه نكتة سوداء وأيما قلب أنكرها نكت فيه نكتة بيضاء حتى تكون القلوب على قلبين أبيض مثل الصفا لا تضره فتنة ما دامت السماوات والأرض والآخر أسود مربادا كالكوز مجخيا لا يعرف معروفا ولا ينكر منكرا إلا ما أشرب من هوى. Dots. If you don't repent, if you resist the sin, if you pass the exam, every day we are in exams regarding our deen and iman. Every day, every hour. Are you acting as a believer in all conditions, in all situations? Are you putting La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah in your mind, in your heart, when you deal with your wife, with your children, when you are at work, when you are traveling, when you are buying or selling, or what are you doing? So if you are sinning, it is very easy to cheat, to deceive people, to sin. There are lusts and desires, especially as the Prophet ﷺ said, it is woman. ما تركت بعد فتنة هي أضر على الرجال من النساء. And he said, لكل أمة فتنة وفتنة أمة المال. يأتي على الناس زمان لا يبالي المرء ما أخذ من مال حلال أم حرام. It will come a time that the person, the man, he doesn't care from where he got his money, halal or haram. And he said, one of the highest trial for my ummah is money, wealth. And because of that, you will be asked about your wealth at the day of judgment. Two questions. From where you got it? How did you spend it? Hadith, لا تزول قدم عبد حتى يسأل عن أربع. You will be asked four questions before moving in the day of judgment. Your lifespan, your life as a whole, and your youth age, as your age is now. Yeah, from 15, 16 till 25. The youth age especially. And then your knowledge. How did you get it? From where you got it? How did you practice it? علمي. ماذا عملت به? What have you done on it? With it. And then when it comes to wealth, you will be asked about your money, your income. How, from where you got it? The second question, how did you spend it? والذين إذا أنفقوا لم يسرفوا ولم يقتروا وكان بين ذلك قواما. يعني look to the questions here. So it is a serious matter. Do you fear Allah when you gain money, when you work? You are going to sell a car to somebody and you know it is damaged. But okay. You are a big shaitan. Okay, this is a wonderful car. Okay. 1,500, I paid it 1,200 for you. Jazakallah khair, thank you. What a good guy. He took the car, after 1-2 days, broken. Harami, you are a thief. You are happy with this 1,200 pounds. You are happy with the money you are gaining from ghish, deceiving. You will be asked about this, about every penny. Yani, it is not a joke. Yeah. So take care. Are you a believer in your heart when you are dealing with others or not? Or you are a munafiq, you are a fasiq, you are running for yourself. And then comes the second question. It is also serious, very serious. What have you done with this money? Very stingy? Miser? You don't want to pay anything for your wife, for your children, for your family? You know that your uncle is very poor and you don't care? You are wasting money? Why one jacket or one suit? Yani you have 10. You have you spend the money for luxurious, and you know that you have people who are in real need. You will be asked, take care. Take care. And this is the iman in your heart. Yani, try to make the balance. The balance between this dunya and the akhirah. Yani, we are belonging to Akhirah. We belong to Akhirah. We don't belong to this dunya. It is very short. If you are indulged in dunya, you are a loser. Yani completely indulged. You will find now the ayat here when we are going to talk about it. One of the main issues of the diseased and dead hearts. They are completely indulged in dunya. Yani they don't think of Akhirah. They don't care. The same as the kuffar. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا يَتَمَتَّعُونَ وَيَأْكُلُونَ كَمَا تَأْكُلِ الْأَنْعَامِ وَالنَّارُ مَثْوًا لَهُمْ. Yani they enjoy their life. They try, or they think. They eat as the cattle. And Allah said their final destination is hellfire. Ya ibn al-halal, we are created for a noble thing. As a Muslimin, we have our own goal and aim. We are looking forward. We are looking for Jannah. We are building our palaces while we are here. And alhamdulillah, Allah gives us everything. You are not deprived from anything. Even if you are a good believer, a pious man, alhamdulillah, you can eat, you drink, you get married, you can get money from halal, you can be very rich, no problem. But the problem is your heart. Is this money embedded in your heart? Are you running for it? How do you think about Akhirah? How do you be committed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When you are rich, your duty is different from being poor. Hadith of Rasulullah SAW, غلب درهم ألف درهم. One dirham, 1 pound. Overcome 1,000 pounds. They said, how, ya Rasulullah? He said, a very rich man, a multi-millionaire, or having 100,000 of pounds. They asked him to pay, or he wants to donate. He paid 1,000 pounds. Another man is very poor. has only £2 in his pocket. He took half of what he had and he paid £1. Rasulullah said, this pound overcome the £1,000. Don't put the worldly issues in your heart. One of the keys for what we are talking about, try to withdraw slowly from this dunya. I am not saying be yani, a zahid or yani, what you call zahid in English, yani, yeah, city? Allah, zahid, yani, you don't take a lot from the dunya, just the necessities.
Abstinence.
Aywa? Abstinence?
Abstinence.
Sah. No, take your halal, but don't open the door in your heart for this. Because you will never be satisfied. As the Prophet ﷺ warned us. Rasul ﷺ knows the hearts. He is curing our souls and our hearts. And he said, son of Adam will never be satisfied with the dunya. وَلَا يَمْلَأُ عَيْنُ ابْنِ آدَمْ إِلَّا التُّرَابِ لَوْ أَنَّ لِبْنِ آدَمْ وَدِيًا مِنْ ذَهَبٍ لأراد أن يكون له وديان ولا يملأ جوف ابن آدم إلا التراب ويتوب الله على من تاب. If you have a valley of gold, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, you will ask for the second valley of gold. يعني you will never be satisfied. This means that you will run and run and run. Then the الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ولا يملأ جوف ابن آدم إلا التراب. When the dust will come in your belly, it will be full of dust. When you die, when you die, يعني you will not be satisfied till your death. Try. I am not saying it is an easy matter because everyone in his nature, you like to get more and more positions. You got more and more money. You want more and more. If you have one woman, you may think about the second wife. You have two children, you wish to get 10 or 20. You have one car, you want another. You have one house, you want two or three. It will never stop. As-Salaf Ridwanullah alayhim, the great Sahaba and the Tabi'een, they said, when you are 40 years in age, prepare yourself for departure, as I said last week. Yani, withdraw a little bit. One of the main issues, don't be highly indulged in dunya. Khalas. Because dunya and akhira are against each other. يعني as durratin. Durratan. Do you know durra in English? يعني you are married to two women. How they fight each other. I know many stories of brothers who married two and they turned his life from being يعني, very happy. People think, Ya Salam, you got two wives. But wala hawla wala quwwata illa billah. Hellfire. Try to put the dunya. No, put the akhirah, your priority. Always think about akhirah. This will cure. This will guide you. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. الصراط المستقيم, the straight path. Rasulullah said, it will start in dunya, it will end with you in paradise. The meaning. So this is our sirat mustaqim. We want to keep ourselves. How? One of the main things here is our heart. Our heart. Detach. Be detached. ياخد الدنيا يعني. You will feel, you will see it. It is worthless. It is nothing. When you get old, you will cry about the years you spend wasting it. It doesn't equal to the wing of a mosquito in the eyes of Allah. Hadith sahih. إِنَّ الدُّنْيَا لَا تُسَوِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ جَنَاحَ بَعُوضَ وَلَوْلَ ذَلِكَ مَا سَقَى كَافِرًا مِنْهَا شَرْبَةَ مَاعٍ. It doesn't worth the wing of a mosquito. And because of that, because it is worthless, Allah gives it to anybody, to any human being. He gave it to the seed, to the worshipper of cow. He gave it to the Christian, to the Jew, to the Hindu, to the Buddhist, to the atheist. But he doesn't give the deen and the iman except to those whom who believe, whom he who loves. Love. And by giving you the iman and make it, establish it in your heart, you are the best, successful, happy man in the whole world. إِنَّ فِي الدُّنْيَا سَعَادَةً لَوْ عَلِمَهَا الْمُلُوكُ وَأَبْنَاءُ الْمُلُوكُ لَجَالَدُونَ عَلَيْهَا. As Imam Ibn Taymiyyah said, there is the great happiness of this dunya. It is knowing Allah and being near and close to Allah. If the kings know this happiness, they will fight us for it. The real happiness is to know Allah, to know Allah, to live with Allah, to love Allah, to fear Allah. He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created you, he knows you best. It is not the dunya. It is very easy. Today you can get money, tomorrow you may lose. After a day you are healthy, the second day you are sick and ill. This is the dunya, dunya, dunya ya'ni. Down, down. How can we know this? By iman, feelings, by knowledge. How can we practice it? It is your problem. It is your problem. And there are many, many obstacles here. There are many things which are going to withdraw you from the straight path. One of them is the shaitan who lives with you. Other thing is your nafs, your soul. If you don't control yourself, you like to be lazy, you want to sleep comfortably, you want to fulfill your desires. If you don't control your soul itself, other things, your partners, the community, the society, people around you. So let us come back to say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the hearts as it is guided by knowing Him, by the Quran, by the Sunnah. مَا أَصَابَ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهُ وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, no disaster strikes except by permission of Allah. And whoever believes in Allah, He will guide his heart. And Allah is knowing of all things. Also in Surah Al-Anfal, the hearts of the believers, when Allah is mentioned, it shakes. They fear Allah. إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. The believers are only those who, when Allah is mentioned, يعني they are reminded, their hearts become fearful. And when His ayat are recited to them, it increases them in iman. And upon their Rabb, they rely. All of this are characters of their hearts. Look here. In Surah Al-Anfal, the second ayah, Allah describes the believers with issues in their hearts. Then the second, the next ayah, it will be about the salah, يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ, and they pay the zakah. And Allah said, they are the real believers. Three characters in your heart should be. I know it is not easy. Many of us suffering from hardship in their hearts. As well as when the Imam here, he said, many people comes to say, I feel hardness in my heart. I don't find any joy in worship. I feel that my faith has hit rock bottom. Reading the Quran does me. I fall into sins very easily. Many things here affecting, reflecting the hardness of the heart. And the contrary, look to the believer's heart. Look to the difference here. That when Allah is mentioned, when you pray at night alone, you cry. Because your heart now is in close relation to your Lord, to Allah. They said Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Umar, there was what you call here, as if there is places beneath their eyes, a tunnel, because of the crying at night. So here in Surah Al-Anfal, Allah said that إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. So they have tawakkul. التوكل يعني something in your heart. You rely on Allah. Yes, it is very difficult. I am in a disaster, but I ask Allah and I rely on Allah. You are in a battlefield, you are in jihad, you are in whatever, very hard conditions. I rely on Allah. Even if the whole world against you, I rely on Allah. I believe in Allah. Whatever Allah wants, it will happen. How can you get these meanings? التوكل على الله والله يحب المتوكلين. It is also an issue in the heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون الذين يقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. Also the guided heart, the dua of the believers in the Quran, ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. Oh Allah, they say, our Rabb, our Lord, Rabbana, let not our hearts deviate after you have guided us and grant us from yourself mercy. Indeed, you are the bestower. قلوب خاشعة تخشع تخشع لله الخشوع. We say الخشوع in Salah. ألم يأني للذين آمنوا أن تخشع قلوبهم لذكر الله. Has not the time come for the hearts of those who believe, the believers, to be affected by Allah's reminder, this Quran, and that which has been revealed of the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the heart, the pious heart, ذَلِكَ وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. Piety in the hearts. Allah says, that is so, and whoever honors the symbols, the rites of Allah, indeed, it is from the piety of his heart. Sha'air Allah. All the things, the lights for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, for men, keep your beard. Don't shave your beard. Halas, I'm obeying the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm doing it. Because I'm following my Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm not doing it to be a handsome man or to be, yani, la. I have one leader. I have one imam. He will guide me to paradise, to Jannah. Khalas. Authentic. Keep your beard, I will keep my beard. Allah said to the women, cover your head, cover your body. Khalas. Sha'ira min sha'ir Allah. Highly honored for the salah. The first and the biggest issue in our deen. The salah. You are living to pray. You are living to pray. So, since you are alive today, five prayers you have to do it. Tomorrow, if you are alive, five prayers you have to do it. Salat al-Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. Do your best to pray in Jama'ah. Do your best to be in the mosque. This is our life. This is our life as a Muslimin. Previously, they know the houses of the Muslims by the light in the darkness. Salat al-Layl. Now even Salat al-Fajr, you don't wake up to pray Salat al-Fajr. How can you think you will be a Muslim or you want mercy from Allah? Hayya ala al-Salah, hayya ala al-Falah. As-Salatu khayrun min al-Nawm. Salah is more, okay, than better than sleeping. And you are sleeping the whole night. Then you wake up running for your work. But where is your Lord? Yeah. Where is your Rabb who created you, who gave you? Do you think you, why are you alive today? Why you are not dead? Because you are intelligent, yani? You are healthy? Ya akhi, Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Salaf said, every day you live, it is a bounty. It is a bounty. Ya ibn Adam, innama anta ayyam. إذا مضى منك يوم مضى جزء منك. As Hassan al-Basri, the great scorer of the Tabi'in. Oh, human being, you are just a day. Every day passes, it is part of you taken. We have to remind ourselves every time and then. This is very important. And this is the characters of the hearts of the believers. I have to finish now because now the timing is 9 o'clock. Inshallah, next week we will continue with the diseased heart and the dead heart. Jazakumullah khair wa sallallahu ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.
We're going to take 15 minute Q&A before we allow the brothers to make wudu for salah. Sisters, if you have any questions, please write a small note and just throw it over and the brothers can pass it through. And if, do you want your note, Sheikh, or do you want to take it straight from the floor?
No problem, Lala, they can.
Any
brother want to ask directly, ask inshallah. The sisters, if they need anything, yes, tell them.
What are the best actions to take to purify your heart?
Okay, this is our lectures. You have to wait with us. Yeah, there are many, many things. And everyone every one of us has his own defect which he knows and the shaitan knows. For example, a man who is very weak towards the woman, for example, he has to try his best. As the Rasulullah ﷺ taught us, fast, get married as soon as possible, lower your gaze. Don't be alone with a single woman, so and so. Another man, his weakness in his heart is being arrogant. He's very arrogant. He looks at himself always. He's looking down to others. Another one, his main problem is wealth, money. He loves money very much. His main concern is to get more and more and more. So everyone has his own way how to cure this. And the good deeds are many. Many, many. Yani we know. Worshipping Allah is the key for everything, especially the secret ways of worshipping Allah. As-siyam, especially Salat al-Layl. And of course, doing the obligation is first. If you are not doing the obligation, don't talk or don't ask. If you don't pray the five prayers, we don't need to talk. Yani, wake up for Salat al-Fajr before anything. It is a major sin to miss Salat al-Fajr. I am not going to say the fatwa of Sheikh Abdul Aziz bin Baz, rahimahullah, one of the greatest scholars of Saudi Arabia. For those who intentionally miss Salat al-Fajr day after day, leave this fatwa to the end of the course, inshallah. It is a major sin to ignore, to neglect waking up for Salat al-Fajr. And I find this يعني, a disaster in this country and in many places, يعني, really. Allah says, وَقُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ. He swear by Salat al-Fajr. إِنَّ قُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ كَانَ مَشْهُودًا. And the Prophet ﷺ said, the highest and heaviest Salah for the munafiq is Salat al-Fajr. So look to your heart. Is there nifaq in your heart? You of course love to stay in your bed, very comfortable. You are with your beloved wife and it is لا يبا. No. Are you a believer? Are you a mu'min? Okay, wake up. And if you are a real believer, switch your car, go to the nearest mosque. No work at 4 o'clock. If you are a weak believer, khalas, okay. Go to wudu and pray with your wife near your bed. You are a weak believer, but this is better than missing Salat al-Fajr. There are many things, inshallah we may go through it in our class.